Welcome back to Truth No Chaser, real talk for real people.
Even when it burns.
It's your girl Ashley.
And Jay.
And Frank.
And we have our dope, beautiful,
yes, sir,
fashionably
yes,
sir, styled guest.
Thank you.
Ashley Nicole.
Hello, hello, hello.
Welcome to TNC.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely, yes, absolutely. I love your hat.
Thank you.
Isn't she fly?
Thank you.
Absolutely.
That's my I love style your hat. Right.
Thank you.
Oh, yes, the compliment to the hat. What about
Jason,
y'all?
I love your hat, too.
Thank you. I mean, it's not a fedora.
All right, we are back with the Naked Truth, where it's all about our guest. So I'm going to read her bio.
Absolutely.
Ashley Nicole was born in Dayton, Ohio. Her parents later relocated to Atlanta, Georgia in 92. She graduated from Miller Grove High School, received a BS in education from Valdosta State University, as well as her master's in education. She currently is a middle school teacher in Clayton County and has been teaching for 8 years. Now, let's talk about fashion. Her love for fashion began once she was older in undergrad and could buy her own clothes without her parents telling her, "Take that off, girl." She looked at social media sites to get inspiration, but the way she wore the clothes is what set her apart. Complete strangers would approach her, asking her the same exact question, "Are you a stylist?" Once she started hearing this over and over, she started to think about the what ifs. Now at 31 years old, she wants to fulfill her passion of being a fashion and wardrobe stylist. She is committed to making her clients not just look fly, but feel fly. Y'all welcome Ashley Nicole to the show.
Yes, yes, yes. Welcome, welcome, welcome. How you doing, Ashley?
I'm well, I'm well. How are you guys doing?
We are great.
We're happy
great
to have you.
Right.
I threw a little style together, just a little bit.
Yeah. I see.
Like a little kill him, but don't kill him.
A little.
Make it look like I wasn't trying, but I really was. But I wasn't, you know what I mean?
You did good. You did good.
Did not.
You know, I've definitely had those dreams before.
Really?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Why wouldn't I? You know what I'm saying? I'm the most stylish person I know. I'm just keeping up 100.
And he says it with a dead ass straight face. You know he does.
I'm trying to come as humble as I know how.
Sorry, not sorry.
As humble as I know how. But you know what I'm saying? Shit, it just is what it is.
No, but I can see you look nice.
But appreciate it. You know, let me talk about teaching real quick first.
Right. Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Before we even, because I a para.
Okay.
At Miller Grove Middle School.
Okay, I went there.
Okay. Yeah. So I. Now, COVID, we starting to phase back in. What's your feelings? I know you can't speak wholeheartedly
on
it.
How much time I got?
just give
segment
us a little bit.
Show segment, go for it.
I'm still overwhelmed.
Absolutely.
It's still surreal to me where we are
right
with education.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in Clayton County, so I'm blessed that I'm in a county that is really valuing their teachers, their students, their staff, and mm-hmm. we have not been in the building since March.
Shout out,
and
Clayco.
Mm-hmm. I really appreciate that because okay. I'm sure you guys see different counties. We have mm-hmm. kids, you know, trying to have them go back hybrid or go mm-hmm. back in the building.
Yeah.
And it's just a lot. As far as the virtual teaching aspect, it's a lot. When we started in March last school year, it was just abrupt. Like, we heard COVID was going on, you mm-hmm. know, we got the word maybe you guys are going to be out, but then we went home Friday normal, you know, bye Miss Curtis, gave me hugs, and we thinking we're going to see each other on that Monday morning, and
right.
I haven't seen a child since.
Yeah.
So think about it. We're leaving school thinking we're coming back.
Right.
Nobody yeah. has laptops. The kids don't have resources.
Yeah.
You know, so the end of the last few months of last school year was just
mm-hmm.
a total, like, it was crazy, you know. So now that we are a little more prepared for virtually, it's still a hassle. Clayton County did purchase laptops for all their students, mm-hmm. so they have laptops. However, it's just, you don't know every child's home environment.
That's
and
right.
and,
yes.
and it's so different, you know.
Yeah.
So trying to teach in so many different, you know, environments, and some students are logging on and they're scholars, the other ones are in the bed with bonnets
yeah.
on,
mm-hmm.
some don't even have their cameras on.
Don't even have the cameras
and I have
on.
To multitask, and I have to teach, and I have to look in the chat box. I have to, it's so much.
It's not an obligation for them to have their cameras on.
Our county, yes, but
it is
for our county.
Well, for the teachers, for the staff, it is. But even for the students,
we put it out there. Hey, I need you.
Yeah.
You have a week of participation points. Half of your points, you need to have your camera on. You need to be active. That's what I do. Yeah. You need to be active. You know what I'm saying? I actually need to be looking at a ceiling fan. I need to see a box. Give me a little tip of the head or something so you can get your points for today.
Right.
So that's I kind of try to incentivize them and kind of, you have to be creative. And in this time, if a teacher is not really passionate about what they're doing,
so you got half-ass teachers.
I'm trying to be creative and do virtual karaoke. If you know, turning your work, we have virtual incentive, virtual, you know, parties. So we have to try to be creative because it's so exhausting.
Every single day, something different. Trying to keep them active.
Yeah, so, there's a lot of people that can relate to you.
In the beginning, we, children's, attention span is very, short. So we did like an 8 o'clock to 1:30 schedule, initially. It was great. But then now we've extended it to the whole day to 3:45. And it's just a lot. Mm-hmm. It's just taxing on everybody.
Yeah.
So y'all pray for us.
Girl, absolutely, yes. But then what you were saying about the camera, man, some of us sometimes it's funny.
I'm calling the roll.
Right,
Johnny,
right.
Are you here? I hear WAP in the background, 8 o'clock in the morning.
Whatever gets him going.
The things I hear.
Don't knock that man morning routine.
Robert,
are you there, sir?
Robert, and then you say, get your ass under there. You hear that?
They in the bed.
You hear that teacher
out.
Calling you? Get your ass in front of the camera.
On camera, sleep.
Right.
If I can't sleep, you can't. It's just parents. at least have your environment in your home where the children are sitting upright and trying to receive instruction,
Just like they would be in class.
Class. Some parents,
would they have their robe on and their bonnet in their bed?
Well, you got Keisha who still sleeps, so she ain't worried about.
And some parents aren't even. Some parents aren't even at home. Bless their heart, they're out working or they're with their grandparents.
Don't judge me. I'm at home with my child. He be skipping class right in front of me.
Oh, James.
Oh, these kids. Well, let me tell you something. These kids.
Break.
Oh, mama, we off for all week today. Oh, mama, we don't have class today. Miss Curtis, she not teaching today.
Class done.
They milking.
I'm gonna be like, yo, we got a project.
They milking the system. Seventh grade, middle school.
My son be like, we got a project.
They be milking it. I say, y'all know what? They be, you looking like if that was me, I'd be the same way.
No shit, I already know. Because I'm working with him. Yeah. I'm in the classroom with him, so I already know exactly what you're talking about.
How's it in the cab?
Now, shout out to the cab, because the cab, we're just now phasing in, and obviously that's a bully system for real. I'm just keeping it 100, you know what I'm saying? Parents bully them into that, you know what I'm saying? But
same thing with Atlanta.
Yeah.
Were the cab parents boycotting? They're in the, not go back, right?
Yeah.
Some.
I ain't out there with them. Nigga need to get paid, you know? But,
you still gonna get paid.
Wait.
Not some, there's some intricacies.
Yeah, because you got some people that did an ADA, FMLA.
It's different,
and stuff like that. So anyway, the cab, they stayed, headstrong for a while, but our superintendent finally gave in, and we phased in today for the first time. So
today, okay.
Tomorrow we'll have the kids, and I don't know when the kids will actually come back in face to face. So we're still in the building virtually.
So even with the cases rising so much in Atlanta and all these new strands, quote unquote, they're going back into the building.
Not only them, but Atlanta. It's Atlanta public schools.
That's Clayton County's thing. We have to have like a consecutive 3 weeks straight of like low numbers. So they're really
That was the rule for Atlanta and DeKalb, but the parents bullied the administration into it.
Yeah.
But
it's
almost like too much like common sense. You see deaths in Gwinnett and you see deaths in Henry. And then now the other kid that deaths in the cab.
So let's go back.
You understand what I'm saying?
We're going over to DeKalb County.
Y'all will be back in the house soon.
Absolutely.
But why even go in?
I was talking to somebody from Cleveland in a day. And she was like, yeah, I was working, and then, when COVID hit again, came back hard again. And I was like,
it never went nowhere.
Came back.
She was like, when we had to go on lockdown again. I was like,
yeah, but it never went.
Not in Atlanta.
Y'all, they be killing me from my Atlanta.
Atlanta did a strong 2 weeks, and we was off punishment.
All the memes on Instagram, Atlanta and Houston, the only ones not in the pandemic.
Girl.
Florida, too, apparently.
Let's switch this over from the teaching aspect real quick.
Yeah.
Because we definitely wanted to have you here because you were just so fly.
Thank you.
So, we seen the bio. People kept saying, are you a stylist and all that stuff? But what really triggered you to say, I want to do this for real? And is it going to be a passion, permanent sometime, or are you going to just continue to teach as well as do both?
great question. So I really, okay, let me answer the first question first. So I always like clothes and I love thrifting. I love just putting things together. So I'm just doing it for me,
right?
You know, and then I just start like distressing denim. That was like a, you know, a trend years ago. Mm-hmm. So I just started doing that. And then people would ask me, where'd you get those jeans from? And then I said, I just made them. I cut them, put them in the washing machine, or, you know, use my razor. And I started doing that first. Mm. And then people were like really, you know, messing with me, like, and I'm like, wow, you know. And then I remember I went to my sister's birthday brunch, and of course I was fly. So I walked in, and this girl was staring at me that I had never seen in my life. So I know I'm my sister's friend, so I'm like, who's this girl staring at me? So later she introduced herself and she was like, who are you? And I was like, huh? She was like, you know, black women, like, if you're staring at me, you got a problem. Like, what you know. Yeah. But she was so, she was so humble, and she was like, who are you? And I was like, what you mean? She was like, what do you do? Like, you. And I was like, I don't do anything. I'm a teacher. And then I can start telling her about, you know, I like fashion. Because she was like, you know, where'd you get this blazer? Goodwill, you know, $7. She was like, really? And I said, you know, I want to be a stylist. I guess it just, I don't even know where those words really came from now that I think about it. But I told her that, a stranger, a complete stranger. And she said, don't ever say that you're not one.
Right.
So she said, when I ask you who you are stylist. And I said, okay, I'm, you know, lit off mimosas. I'm like, girl, talk, oh, okay. All right. So she was just like, you know, just speaking life into me.
Right.
You know, a complete black woman who's a stranger, and I look good, she look good, and the fact that she still extended that to me.
Yeah.
So that was just life changing to me. And then I said, you know, I can do this, you know? So I just said, well, I really want to kind of just style some friends for free and kind of see, you know, how that goes. Like, what do I charge? What I'm supposed to, you know? Yeah. So I just kind of played with it. And then the end of 2016, I was on my winter break, and I said, you know, I really want to, I thought about some names, and I said, I really want to make a business out of it. Mm-hmm. So I spent my last $100 to purchase my LLC, and that's how I knew I was serious. Because I was living by myself in a loft downtown. I'm a teacher, so I ain't have it like that. And that's how I knew. You know, I was serious. And then I just, you know, I had a launch party, and I just, you know, kind of built my brand, had a website, and then I just start promoting. And people really support me that I don't even, you know, that I didn't even know, or, you know, that I didn't really think was paying attention. Mm-hmm. And then I just, you know, got, I guess it built my confidence more, and that's just where I am today.
You style for men? You style for men?
I do. I love men's fashion. This is a men's shirt I thrifted.
So when you start seeing us a little flyer up here on this show, just know Ashley Nicole.
Yeah, we have a photo shoot coming up pretty soon too. So
I need you to style me for the photo shoot.
Mm-hmm. Y'all got my information. I love I love men's fashion.
Me, not him.
He doesn't need a flyest one. Of course, that he knows. He doesn't need one.
Need it. But I love
James Harden over here. I don't need that sis, baby.
I love, like, just I go to photo shoots, I style them, or I just love those clients to say, you know, I'm trusting you, and I put you in something. It's like, I never would have bought this for me, but I love me in it. Like, I love that. That gives me gratification. So I love styling, and I really, to your second question, I definitely want to do it. Like, I want to travel, and I used to have the dream, I want to style celebrities. But now, like, then I'm an entrepreneur, and I know so many successful black men, black women. Like, I just want to like y'all. Let me style y'all for a show. Like, I just want to style influential black people that's going to speak at a women's conference.
First of all,
you know what I'm saying?
Let me get that email address.
First of all, say less. Then she called us influential.
Hey, you
successful.
You see what I'm saying? Like, I want to style people I can relate to. I don't really, I can style with celebrities. I would love to style anybody.
Yeah.
But I really want to style people who have an influence, and who are, you know, inspirational, and people that are not just celebrities, you know.
Right.
And that's my goal, to just travel and style. And I love education, but, you know, I don't want to do it forever.
Right.
I do have goals to, you know, take it, you know, be bigger and better, and, you know, make it a full time.
You ever do a fashion show? You ever do a fashion show for your
Let me tell you something. What I did
in school,
in college.
Tell us.
This is another thing. I'm so glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
In college, this is how I know I really wanted to do it too. I was sleeping. You know, when you just have this burning idea, like I woke up out of my sleep.
Like an epiphany.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I woke up out of my sleep and I said, I want to do, I was student teaching, because to be a teacher and get certified, you got to do a whole year of student teaching. And I was in a school that was just, you know, an impoverished area. And I said, I want to do a fashion show. And the proceeds can go, I can buy school supplies and coats and jackets and everything for my school I'm at.
Oh, wow.
And I have a friend who was a teacher as well. And I shared with her my idea and she loved it. And we put on a bomb fashion show. Mm. We raised so much money. We were able to sponsor my school, her school, and another school in Valdosta. It was a great event. And that's how I said, yeah, like, this is it. So I did that in Valdosta. And I always said I want to do it once I graduate and do one bigger and better in Atlanta, you know. So that's still, you know, maybe in the workings. But yeah, I put together a fashion show and it was amazing. It was amazing.
So you mentioned you had you got your LLC. I didn't see that in the bio. So what is the name?
It's Ashley Nicole Styles, yeah. But yeah.
So say it again so everybody can hear you again.
Ashley Nicole Styles, yeah.
And you have a website?
Mm-hmm. AshleyNicoleStyles.com.
One more time.
AshleyNicoleStyles.com. All right. And then my Instagram, AshleyNicoleStyles1.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So my question is, so you want to style someone? And you can use her example, me. Come and say, hey, look, I need some styling. Where do you start? What's point A?
I have a free hour consultation. So, hey, girl, you know, I've been doing Zoom since, you know, COVID. But usually I meet with the person. I have like a, you know, consultation form. What do you like? You know, where do you shop? What don't you wear? What won't you wear? You know, are you open to this? Do you not want to show your legs? Do you know, do you not like to wear black? Do you only like to wear black? Just to get to know and feel the client. And so that's my starting point, to see, you know, who they are as a person, you know, kind of see how they dress. I like to go on their social media to kind of see, you know, what they do, what they put on, and then kind of throw out some questions. Well, would you, you know, wear this? Or what do you think about this? Or, you know, what's a celebrity or somebody that you know, idolize, you know, or they inspire you with how they dress? So that consultation really is where that's my starting point for styling clients that I don't know or I'm not really familiar with.
Right.
That's just how Ashley would be an easy project, right? She'd be a fairly easy project to, you know, person style, you think?
Why you say that?
You know,
yeah, Frank, why you say that?
Because, you know, model-esque, model-esque, you know what I'm saying? Like, tall, you know, I mean, it seems like those type, her body structure is not hard to figure out. Like, so, like, a person like me, right, or, like, you know, I guess, symmetrically, I'm not, like, you know, perfectly built and shape, you know what I'm saying? Got a bigger stomach than a... I got no ass, right? So it's like hard to hear, say what I'm saying. Shit like that. You know what I'm saying? So like, you know, she just always strike me as, you know, a model anyway. Like,
definitely.
You know,
I get that.
Yeah,
thank
so
you. Get that vibe.
You know, so I would just assume that somebody, you know, of her, you know, height, you know what I'm saying, and everything would be
not necessarily. Not, I mean,
and nothing's a challenge for you. You can kind of
that, yeah, but it's like, even if someone wasn't model-esque or, you know, I like to bring people out of their shell. So even if you don't have the figure that you just want to have, like, I want to, my goal, my job, I want to make you feel good.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm going to put you on something still skimpy or something still sexy, even if, you know, to say, hey, oh, I can wear this,
in the spirit of meet the parents. I'm not model-esque. Can you style me?
Right.
Yeah.
So listen, all right, so I know I can wear anything with you then. All right, cool. So when I reach
anybody,
for that speedo, don't be
right. Do it.
When I reach for that
do
speedo,
it.
He said, not just look fly, Frankie, but feel
but see,
it.
But I like
feel
what, it. I like what feel you said it. Though, because you know I'm trying to get rid of my dad body, and
that's
body.
What I'm starting to get.
The dad
yeah,
body.
That's what I'm starting to get.
The dad body.
Yeah, the stomach is just protruding more and more.
It happens. But, you know, raising kids, running the household, whatever. But you know. I need my style to come with me as I'm mature.
And until you get there, you can still be stylish. You don't have to get rid of the dad belly.
Yeah, they don't make.
You know what I'm saying?
They don't have that section.
They don't have that
kind of. You gotta. No.
She can find it. Y'all trying to tell you? She said she can find it for y'all.
No.
Yeah. That's kind of tough. You gotta be selective when you got that.
Yeah, you gotta shop.
You
gotta
shop. Fashionable. You got the cardigan.
I mean, it's harder than we make
it look.
I'm sorry,
Jake. And then look at you.
But I'll be risque with my shit. You know what I'm saying?
And that's what I'm saying. You don't have to be model-esque. Anybody can be risky. Lizzo. Lizzo is confident in herself.
Super confident.
And I love it.
Yes.
I love it.
She breeds that, yes.
You know, and I think, you know, we got to get out of that. Oh, she's...
We don't have no men Lizzos.
men losers.
We have no Mizzos.
We got Spice Adams.
What are some
y'all in time out? When it comes to styling someone,
yeah, funny.
What are some of the do's and don'ts?
That for me to style someone? Mm. Do's and don'ts.
Do's and don'ts, you can say that about them,
right?
I like that. Go with that.
What's
that? You
said what?
She ain't got no don'ts.
Yeah. Things that I like shouldn't do, or the client shouldn't like. What do you mean?
Either way.
Yeah.
Or somebody said, you know, I'm having trouble styling myself for a wedding or any function, you know, and they would say, I want to go this way, and you know, is there like for different seasons, you know, the do's and don'ts, or is there different attire for weddings, or you know, stuff like that?
Oh yeah, I got you. Okay. I think that's a very broad question, but okay, for weddings, I feel I've styled people for weddings. I don't really, well, now I think it's a modern thing. Like, I used to think that black is not for weddings. But now people, that's the, you know, the attire.
Facts.
You know?
I just wore black.
So and it looks, in pictures, it looks good.
You
black.
A day wedding?
A day wedding?
Yeah, okay. No.
Like a day wedding in the spring. A day wedding in the spring.
No.
I feel like a day wedding in the spring, you need to have on, you know, light colors,
like
you know.
Easter,
you know.
Colors, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Maybe a little pastel.
A little pastel. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
A little, some light color.
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
So what's in style right now? Some of the dudes that you must have in your closet right now,
right
for men
now,
or women.
Sure. I love like comfy, tomboy, girly. So I have so many joggers. Mm. Like, you know, for women, it's kind of the joggers, dressing it up with heels. Mm-hmm. I like that look.
I'm
taking tips.
That's it now. And then like the camouflage jackets, men and women, you can wear a camouflage jacket with anything. I wear it. My dad was in the army. I actually had my
sweatpants and some heels next week.
Right, I'm gonna have some joggers on next week, some heels. Ashley told me you can do it.
Anything though, like the camouflage jackets, you put it on with anything.
Yeah,
like hats, fedoras, like fitted caps. Mm-hmm. I think that's in. Let me see what else. I think right now, for the most part, it's just that comfortable cute, like that comfortable, right. even for men, like just comfy but still kind of, you know.
What's on the feet for the men? What's on the feet?
Right now,
like,
Tim's.
Like Tim's?
You know, those go with everything.
Yeah, I'm from New York.
You know,
all the time.
Okay.
They never went outside of us.
You wear with everything. Black ones, the wheat ones.
We wear Tim's with our pajamas. But, but I'm a big Chelsea boot fan.
Yes, I love the Chelsea boots.
Yeah, I
love
Chelsea.
This is the season right here.
I love, Monk strap. Shoes, double monk strap shoes.
Chelsea boots, dress down, dress up.
Like, you can wear them jeans. You can wear them, yeah.
I love the Chelsea boots.
Chelsea boot is probably the dopest one, the dopest trends right now. What about outside of like formal wear, or like what about sneakers? Like, what's a this season?
You know,
I want to say J's, but it's certain J's.
And
it's
that's what J's. I was gonna. I love J's, but yeah. I'm kind of, you know, kind of. I like just Nike running shoes, you know, just kind of, you know, Reebok's coming back out. Mm-hmm. So I think J's is kind of like, it's still going to always be cool.
Always.
However, it's not like to me, oh, they got J's on. That's to me, that's not
the trend anymore.
Depending
on how it's dressed up, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to go
Yeezy
hard.
But just.
No, I don't.
I'm not a Yeezy fan. I have one pair of Yeezy sneakers. His sneakers are dope.
You think so?
Some of them. Yeah, I like some of them.
I like some of the newer ones, 700, but
Jordan. I like some of
Jordan 1 fan.
I like 1s and the 12s. The 1s and 11s.
See, well, you know where I would be different.
1s, 11s. And then I love the 7s.
He 11 fan too, I think.
I love the
11. No, I'm not 11. I mean, I got some I'm a 4. 6 and 4 guy.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
The 1s have become my favorite.
Okay.
Because they go with a lot.
I like the.
They go with everything.
They go with everything.
They just
go with
everything. And
they don't make bad colorways.
Those were like, I've worn them with like dressed up with dresses. The ones like Jordans with dresses. Mm-hmm. Like the ones. Those are the ones you can dress up to and dress down.
I remember it was crazy. I was getting a custom suit done, right?
Yeah.
And I had to run and go pick up my newest suit. Mm-hmm. And I was just running errands. So I took my loafers off and I had on some ones. And I was like, whatever. And I went in there and I went in some slacks, you know, some tapered slacks, you know, sport coat, button up. And there was a bunch of like all white, you know, cookie cutter businessman sitting there waiting on they suits too. I'm sitting in the lobby and they all looking at my shoes. The dude was like,
but you know, that's the thing,
man,
right?
They was, and my man suits was like, sneakers? When did you get those ones? And I was like, I never thought that it was a thing.
That's the thing. Even at weddings, like nice suits and like a nice crisp pair of sneakers, like a white sneaker or like not too. It's a wedding, so you don't want to do
Teach his own.
You don't think so? You don't like that look?
They say you're not supposed to outstar, you know, outshine the folk.
Look at Frank.
Frankie Glenn don't never wear sneakers to a wedding.
Uh oh.
Sooner than booty. Sooner than booty.
Let me ask you, do you ever dress down? Is it?
I'm dressed down.
You dress down now?
That's it. But still fly.
No. I wear, thank you.
I dress that like, what do you wear to Kroger? Like, you don't wear this to Kroger, do you? I was about to say, shit.
Oh, yeah. Let me tell you, I have not put on, this is probably maybe the first day I put on jeans because I've been working from home for a very long time.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, I love like sets, like, you know, tie dye, like jogger sets. Like, I like that, like in sneakers. But yeah, I dress down a lot.
Oh, okay.
So what is one of the hardest parts of the fashion styling world? Like, what do you run into where you're just like, oh my god, this client is hard to deal with, or have you ran into a hard client?
Yeah, I have. But now with COVID, I'm doing everything where I was doing everything online.
Mm-hmm.
So when a client needs something, and let's say we already know we ordering packages and they're coming late, or especially when COVID's first, you know, hit, like packages are like a month late. So that has kind of been annoying now, just trying to work online and having to really go off of it. You know, it says it's coming today, but they're not, but the client needs it for a wedding, or the client needs it for, you know,
ASAP.
So so lately that has kind of been an issue. But I've kind of gone back into some stores, but I'm still doing mostly online. But that's the thing, like, even if the express shipping sometimes it's not coming, you know. So that's been some issues lately, and, you know, I'm on the end, like, I'm sorry, you know, it's nothing that I could do, but I still, you know, trying to good customer service, so I kind of, you know, do something to kind of fill that gap so they can still be prepared. So. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So let's travel to the future, right? 10 years from now, Ashley Nicole Styles is popping, right? Speaking into existence.
Yes. I received it.
Yes. Who's... I got a feeling we know what she's going to say. Because everybody always says it.
What?
Who's your absolute dream celebrity to...
She's going to say somebody different.
Just because I said that, right?
I know she is.
What?
I'm going to purposely say somebody that's
off the wall.
Right, don't say like Jacquees just because you're fucking
with him. You're
right. But you probably know him, right?
The singer?
Yeah. Know him personally, right? Like, he's from here. Didn't he go to Bethune or whatever? But, so...
The King of R&B.
Yeah, you got $2 on it?
Yeah,
you got $2 on it?
$2? Okay. What's the question?
So the question who's your star celebrity you want to style? Uh-huh. Like, oh my God, I would just be in heaven.
That I want to style?
Mm-hmm.
Rihanna.
Oh,
I would have lost my $2.
Because I love her.
She's
one of them. She's so, and it's so bold and risky. It's just like nobody would think to do what she do. That's what I like. That's fashion.
That's
fashion.
That's
actually a good
fashion.
I think that's why a lot of guys like her.
She's
because she don't. She doesn't necessarily have all of the features that would say a guy would be like, oh, Rihanna's sexy. But the way she presents herself, and it's just like, I never thought
nobody
of that.
Else can do that. Sexy. She's sexy, but it's just like what she wears. Like, to me, fashion is not just putting on a Gucci outfit.
Turn the music down, please. Because I want everybody.
Everybody on Facebook, everywhere, YouTube, everywhere.
Say it again and look in that camera and say it again, please.
Fashion is not just putting on a Gucci outfit, baby. That's not fashion.
That's what a lot of these motherfuckers think.
That's not to me.
No,
you speaking
I'm not
truth.
An expert.
No. She's speaking to truth.
Us.
Speaking no pun intended.
To me, I can go in Target, and that's my store. Go and get this pair of pants, or jeans. Mm-hmm. I can go to Goodwill, get this blazer.
Come on, girl.
I get my blazers from Goodwill.
She preaching.
I can go to Aldo, get me a fedora.
Mm-hmm.
Preaching.
I can go to H&M or, you know, and that to me is fashion. That's an art. Fashion is an art.
We are
the canvas, right?
Mm-hmm. Come on now.
Right?
Absolutely.
And then the art is the fashion.
Mm-hmm.
The art is not going to buy a whole Gucci fit that somebody else had the eye to make. You just put it on.
I got a pair. Ooh,
that's my opinion. That's just my opinion.
Thank you.
No, I said talking.
That's the gospel, girl. That's the gospel.
So Rihanna is one because she just does what the hell she wants to do, and she don't live beyond. She don't. She live in her own in her own means. That to me, I would love to style her. That's one.
Is there a second one? Because you said that's one. Like there's maybe.
I was trying to think about a man.
She just reignited my crush on Rihanna.
What? Did anybody think I was gonna say Rihanna?
No.
Nah. We all thought y'all owe me $2.
They thought she was gonna say Michelle Obama.
Yeah. Why would y'all think?
Because everybody says they come here, they want to style.
Why would y'all think?
We had $1.
Why would y'all think that?
Why would we think Michelle Obama?
Yeah, I
don't. She probably would. Yeah, right.
Because your name would go through the roof.
That would be top notch. And then plus, she looks just looks like a person.
Yes.
You know, so much class.
She's fun too.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely. I would. Yeah,
love her.
Yeah.
Her, oh, I love her so much. She was bomb at the inauguration.
There you go.
Woo.
You can't see yourself putting that together.
Oh, I can see.
Yeah,
oh,
exactly.
Oh, baby. Mm-hmm. I can take Michelle. Mm-hmm. And I love, like, my goal is I like to be, like, risky. Mm-hmm. So I could definitely see me, you know, getting her. I want to get you out your shell, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you, said, so you man? Said men. You
yeah.
said, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I got to hear this.
I thought y'all was going to see it.
We didn't forget, girl.
Me.
A man,
what man is rocking Ashley Nicole, styled by Ashley Nicole?
Yes. Let's see. I don't know.
Athlete. You think athlete?
Actor.
Rapper.
We all over the place.
I like Michael B. Jordan.
Whoa!
Because his body ain't anything to me.
That's the
AC. It's the body. It's the body for me. It's the body in any like he could rock anything. He can rock anything.
A new coach model,
but another girl was gonna be Janae Aiko. Like I love her.
Oh, yeah.
She's
really sexy,
she's carefree. Too.
Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm. I can see that.
I love her music.
So are you all about it. Taking chances and the risk and just coming
see
out
where I'm
the
going?
Show?
Yeah, that's me.
You like the risky stuff.
Yeah,
okay, I like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's my personality. Yeah.
There you go.
She came
my last question: the apostrophe. On your what's
semicolon.
Oh,
you didn't see this.
Oh, I didn't see that.
But you didn't see this.
Okay,
you're right.
Okay. So what's that going? What's going on with that?
This represents, of course, periods mean you know the end of a statement, the end of something. But semicolon, after you when you use a semicolon correctly, you know it's not the end of something. You have more to say, right? So this represents that my story is still being told and it's not over.
Let's continuation.
Damn. Yo, don't you hate when people have dope ass tattoos and meanings and you like fuck I can't talk about that shit.
Why did I get that tattoo?
Damn.
My story is not over.
It's still being written.
That's dope. How long have you had that?
Hijacking
3-4 years. I'm an English teacher, so my kids be like, Miss Curtis, why you got a semicolon on you? I said, well, how do you use a semicolon?
I
make it a lesson.
I'm an ELA teacher. So I'm happy that they know in middle school that's a semicolon. So that's
and if they don't, I teach them.
Yeah, kudos. Shout out to Clayco for knowing what a semicolon is.
Clayco.
A lot of grown folks don't know what a semicolon is.
Yes, a lot. Because I definitely was calling
the
project.
No, but you didn't see the, yeah.
Because
you
were right.
Yeah, I didn't see it until she wrote.
So shout out to myself.
My question, I guess, I might say this is my last question. So I'm gonna accept the challenge. So you've been talking about how risky, you like how people are risky with their styles. You know me a little bit. Mm-hmm. Spend some time around me. You got a feel for me.
Yeah.
What risk? Like, give me a like. Okay, I would put this on you, and you take the risk. Cause I'm gonna follow up on it.
Color, bright colors.
She said that.
Every time I've seen you, it's been, and it might have been the season. Cause when we.
Nah, that's just me.
See, I was trying to.
Oh, Ed with scissor hands looking at him. Yeah. Oh, dark
color. Color. Bright colors.
It's something to pop.
Right.
Cause you've always had dark colors on.
I'm gonna post something this week.
Brighten it up.
Wear my red hat next week. And shit.
Yeah, give me a bright hat.
Baby steps into it. Some
and
shit,
then you man. Can do, you know, you can do denim in a dark shirt, but you can have like a vibrant blazer or a pattern blazer or you know a pattern or colors.
I do patterns.
What's the hot
patterns
color?
And colors?
What's the hot color right now?
Hot color.
See. Sorry, that's my problem. I don't chase what's in pink. My father, and my, I get this from my father. My father's like, yo, we the same way. I wear the classics. So I don't really.
Ashley Nicole's gonna style you. So let Ashley Nicole tell you.
Yeah, but I'm saying like,
tell her what you use.
Take
to.
A wrist, Jay. Okay?
No, it's not. That's not a wrist thing. Like, I don't like if it's. I don't care if it's in style or not. It's all if it's a classic. It's always in fashion.
When you say classic, Tim's. That's classic.
That's classic.
What else?
Okay.
Polos. That's classic.
Polo what?
Oh, you see her face?
I'm saying like a polo shirt, style shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Polo style shirt. What?
Not the brand. You talking about just a polo
not
brand?
The polo style shirt. Yeah. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Like that's.
But that's what she's saying. She's saying branch out and then,
yeah,
but she was more so talking about the color being popular.
Yeah, I'm saying, but
brand. She didn't care about the brand.
Not the brand. That's what I'm saying. Like, so, like y'all get you ask, yo, what are men wearing on their feet right now?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She just asked what the colors are right now. I'm like, I don't give a fuck what they doing right now.
You gonna do the classic?
I can take a color risk, but still be classic.
And that's the thing. That's the thing. Color? Like, I don't want my clients to not feel. Mm-hmm. Like they're not themselves, you know what I'm saying? But just like you said, I can take a risk, you know. But I'm still gonna be me. I'm still gonna be Jay. I'm still gonna be Ashley. Right. You know what I'm saying? So that's and I don't want to take that away from anybody,
right?
But I just like to, you know, get people out of their shell a little bit. So some colors.
Before we get up out of here, for those that are watching, they're thinking like, you know, I want to be a stylist. I might have like the little eye, whatever.
Okay.
What are some of the things you can give them? Some of the gems, the jewels you can drop on them.
Okay. I'm still learning myself, guys. So I would just say when I have consultations or when I'm selling a client, I say if you're questioning it or if you're saying this don't go, do it. Do it.
Mm-hmm.
Like color block.
Mm-hmm.
This don't go. Do it. Just do it.
Gotcha.
If you had the idea, if you put it on, do it. Own it.
Yeah.
Be you. Be true to yourself. You know, don't think about how this is going to look. Because somebody, you're going to turn somebody's head.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Just do it. Be risky. Take, you know, just be bold. And if you have to question it or ask, just do it. Just try it out.
Absolutely.
Try it out.
All right. Go ahead and drop those that website again and your Instagram before we get up out of here.
AshleyNicoleStyles.com is my website. My Instagram is AshleyNicoleStyles1.
And it's spelled the correct way, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
A-S-H-L-E-Y.
Yep. Yes. the correct
and Styles,
way.
Styles, there's no Z or anything like that. It just, you know,
it's, she's classy, yo. She's classy. It's Ashley Nicole.
No Z. I thought about it, though.
Well, we appreciate you stopping by,
thank
TNC.
You for
and we are
going to
hit
y'all.
You up for our photo shoot we're doing in March.
Stop me, Ashley, not him.
He don't need it.
He don't need it. He's a much Styles person. He knows. Anyways.
We're going to
we'll
have you on the show again before you blow up. Yes, please. I had fun with you.
She gave her Instagram one more time.
Instagram one more time, go.
Ashley Nicole Styles 1, the number one.
Number one.
Right.
All right. Well, we appreciate you stopping
Thank
by,
you.
TNC. Don't forget about us when you blow up, girl. All right.
Gotcha.
Y'all check her out. We'll see y'all next time. Peace.
Peace.
No chaser.